Hi everyone, thanks for joining me. It's been a long time. There have been quite a few changes since my last in-person video. One, well, I've grown another chin and I've gotten some gray hair. But on the personal front, there's been a lot. I bought a new house. I am so happy. The day job, I've got lots of projects, so I have been really in it. My wine travels have not been quite at the level that I'd like, but in the last year, I have attended the Pinot and Paella, which was last year in 2016, and I recently returned from a five-day trip to Southern Oregon to the Rogue Valley AVA. A lot of fun, and I'm doing postings on it right now. But one thing I wanted to do was to share with you a wine that I found. And this is, if you can see it, it is Chalk Hill 2016, Chalk Hill Chardonnay. Now the reason I decided to do a review is because it's a 2016. Chalk Hill normally does their wines in different types of oak, anywhere from 100% French to a blend of oaks, American, Hungarian, and French oak. And the times in barrel are usually from 10 to 15 months. So having a 2016 that has just recently been released, I'm going, how long did they have it in barrel? A week? So I decided to go ahead and review this to see if I like it. Now, my weekly psalm tasting, because there are several of us who are sommeliers, and we taste wines in order to be able to develop our palates even more. So I decided to go ahead and try this. This is Chardonnay week, and I think I want to bring this, but I'm not going to bring it if I don't like it. Okay, it looks like it's not a very pale yellow, but a very pale gold. Maybe with just a touch of green. It has some body on it, which speaks to probably some malolactic fermentation. I would not be surprised, because Chalk Hill, first of all, Chalk Hill is one of my favorite wineries. They make beautiful Pinots, and their Chardonnays, I have to admit, their Chardonnays absolutely speak to me. Oh yeah, there's definitely oak there. I'm getting kind of a creamy character. I'm getting a little bit of pears. Maybe even a, I think it's stretching it to say white peach. But I'm definitely getting apples. And there's even maybe just a slightest touch of smoke. And when I say smoke, I mean like the wisp you get from like a pipe smoke that's really fragrant, but it's very fleeting. Wow. Okay, I like it. Surprising finish. Really surprising finish. Okay, it's not too early. Anyway, what I'm getting is a touch, good acidity, especially for a what I would call a California Chardonnay, where you would expect all the butter and butterscotch and no acidity. Really good acidity. Apples, definitely pears. A little bit of creaminess, surprising fruit. Good acidity, and there's actually a little bit of minerality on the finish. The finish is what I would call medium long. I like this. You would never mistake it for a Burgundy or a Chablis. Not ever, not even for a minute. You would know right away that this is a California Chard. And I have to say, I think it's delicious. And like I said, I'm blown away. This is Chalk Hill. This is Chalk Hill. Their high-end Chardonnay is $75. Yes. I haven't gone over the $45 Chardonnay, which is spectacular. So I can only imagine what the $75 Chardonnay tastes like. $19.99. I have seen it online as low as $12.99, $12.98, whatever, a bottle. So you know that the case is just going to be quite the deal. Once again, this is 2016 Chalk Hill, Sonoma Coast, one of my favorite Chardonnay and Pinot regions. $19.99. You cannot go wrong. I got it. Did I say I got it at Trader Joe's? Anyway, I got it at Trader Joe's, but you can get it anywhere at any of the wine vendors online. Enjoy. Thanks for joining me, and I promise I will be back soon. I won't stay away as long. Thanks. See you next time, really soon.